Hi friends, in the previous video I have shown how to show the previous month's value in the on the current month value. So in the tooltip here we are showing the previous month's value. Now I'm going to write a calculation. Instead of previous month, we will display the label as November. For suppose here we are showing seeing the December value 69546 and previous month value 78629, but the label we are showing as a previous month. Instead of previous month, we will display November. So let me create a calculated field. Right click and create a calculated field. So my idea is here is to extract the month month value. So first I will take the month value. So I will use lookup function again here, month of order date. In the view we have the order date, so we will extract month of order date. We will take month of order date. So offset is previous minus 1 for previous value. So we have the error saying that it should be aggregated. So you can write some aggregation function here, min of. Okay, click OK and let me drag this calculation to the tooltip. So if you see month number is 11, so which is correct for the December. So here we don't get anything, that's fine. And for February month number is coming as November 1, yeah correct. And for March it is coming as 2. So instead of previous month, we will use this calculation as the label. So change this one as this. Let me remove this one and click OK. So now we have the number. Let's convert this one in a date format. So we can make use of makeDate function to convert individual measures into a date field. So year of order date, comma. So we don't consider the month, just give one. That's it. Now we have year, month, and date. There is an error. So the makeDate function cannot be applied to table calculation and fields from the multiple data source. So as you know, lookup function is a table calculation. So the error is saying that we cannot apply the makeDate function here. So what I will do is I will write the calculation case function. So case, when this function returns 1, then give me January. Similarly write for all the months. Just I will give the short names Jan, Feb. Let me know in the comment section if you find any better way to get solution for this problem. 3 and 4, then so and so on. I will end it here. You can write for all the months. Let me rename as previous month label. Then click OK. Let me remove this one and drag to the tooltip again. going to insert previous month label. Click OK. So now if you see here, we have the February value. Let me highlight. We have the January value, January label displayed in the February, and February label is displayed in the March. So our calculation is working fine. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel.